my pastors, please, after I've traveled with Andres, we reached some places where it's only the grace of God that can work. Only. If you don't hear God there, you can even be attacked. You understand? You can even be attacked. I'm begging you in the name of God. Some of you, you've been prophesied that, okay, leave Charis, we are jealousing you, you'll be a prophet. Are you hearing God? Now, as long as you are there, you are hearing God, it's fine. Hear God, show us you are hearing God. Because what is important now is what? Hear God, show us you are hearing God. Don't mislead the people of God. And either they will attack you or you attack them. But if you attack them, it won't stay far. So don't mislead them because you want money. Me and Andres, we have reached a place where you just need to hear God when you do things. If not, I'm praying that my pastors here, don't cry for pulpit without doing what? Hearing God. Because there's too much. There's too much more than preaching. Than what? People need to be ministered to. They know the Bible. They can read for themselves. They want to hear the mind of God. So now, it's going to be very hard for our people. Please, you pastors, I'm begging you in the name of God. Don't ever say, me, I'm wasting your time. I've never wasted anybody's time. I've tried to test people by my pulpit here, you were around. I've never. If you want to give me to give you a pulpit, I'll give you. You tell us what God is telling us. But is it God speaking with you? So if now I release you before God speaks with you, oh my God, oh Jesus, you won't survive. You will collect money. This money will eat you up.